受賞者の皆様にお話を伺いたいと思います。お並びの順にお願いいたします。まず絵画部門のマルシャル・レイスさんからお願いいたします。
C'est toujours un peu compliqué pour un artiste, surtout comme moi qui vis dans la solitude la plus complète et qui brusquement, en plus d'une année, s'est retrouvé monté près des étoiles et même sous les sunlight. C'est une chose curieuse et étonnante. Il y a même du jus d'orange maintenant près de moi. Et simplement, je voudrais vous dire que c'est très touchant de voir tellement de personnes qui se sont déplacées pour parler de l'art. Nous vivons une période d'une grande cruauté avec des horreurs que l'on n'aurait pas imaginé voir revenir. Et contrairement à ce que l'on pense, parce que quand on est dans notre milieu, on voit des articles, il y a des gens à la mode, il y a de l'argent qui est dépensé. Mais le monde de l'art et de la culture est extrêmement petit par rapport aux forces et aux violences de l'argent et de la haine. Alors, je voulais simplement vous dire, ayons du courage, continuez de l'avant, tâchons de faire de plus en plus faire connaître l'art. Et je vous remercie d'être tous là. Et j'espère que vous allez passer, nous allons passer un très bon après-midi, parce qu'il faut toujours vivre dans le temps présent.
ありがとうございました。続いて彫刻部門のジュゼッペ・ペノーネさん、お願いいたします。
J'aimerais remercier le prince Itachi, la Japan Art Association et les conseillers internationaux qui m'ont confié ce prix. C'est un grand honneur, je suis très touché et honoré de cette grande distinction. Mais je veux aussi remercier le Japon. Le Japon comme pays qui a développé une culture qui a eu une très grande influence dans l'art depuis le 19e siècle et qui a encore une influence aujourd'hui. C'est un pays qui, ça suffit de rappeler Matisse, Van Gogh, Brancusi, Fontana, tous des artistes qui ont été influencés par la pensée japonaise. Moi, la première fois que j'étais au Japon, c'était dans les 70. Et j'étais invité à une exposition qui s'appelait, c'était une biennale de Tokyo, qui s'est déroulée dans le bâtiment du musée d'art contemporain de Tokyo, qui à l'époque était à Ueno. Et j'ai vécu une dizaine de jours à Tokyo et j'ai vu toutes les cérémonies, les temples qui étaient à Tokyo, qui étaient à Ueno surtout. Et ça m'a touché et je crois que ça a beaucoup marqué mon travail. C'est un travail qui est en lien avec la matière. Et j'essaie de rendre visible la forme qui est à l'intérieur de la matière. Et c'est comme essayer de révéler la spiritualité qu'il y a dans la matière même. C'est ça, quand j'arrive à faire ça, j'espère que ça aide les gens à voir la beauté et la spiritualité qu'il y a dans les choses qui nous entourent et les préserver, et préserver la nature. Parce que l'art n'est pas seulement une valeur esthétique, mais c'est une valeur qui a une fonction éthique. Et c'est ça qu'il faut poursuivre et qu'il faut reconnaître à l'art. Merci de votre attention.
ありがとうございました。続いて建築部門のスティーブン・ホールさん、お願いいたします。
Well, it's a great honor to be here, and I thank everyone involved at the Japan Arts Association. But for me, it's a triple honor. I think it's really a triple honor. First, because I feel deeply that architecture is so important in the arts, and I really love the way that architecture becomes part of painting, sculpture, music, And I mean, I believe that Winston Churchill said, first we shape our buildings, and then they shape us. So this is one. This is the one honor that's very important. It's probably, for me, it's the most important award that I'll ever get, because all the other ones are just about architecture. My second is I'm grateful that my work in architecture as a teacher and the few buildings that I've made, where I'm focusing on the phenomena and the experience of architecture, is recognized and in this award. But the third, and I follow Giuseppe Pannoni, is about Japan. Japan gave me my first chance to be published as a young architect. In 1978, Toshio Nakamura from ANU published a special issue, special 5 pages. I didn't have an issue worth of work. And it was an amazing experience. And he was the first to bring me to Japan to lecture in 1986. And then there I met Arata Izasaki, who gave me my first building that I had as an architect of any consequence, which is still there in Fukuoka, Japan. So I've been here maybe 50 times now, and I feel that this award makes me like, I feel like I'm coming home to where culture really counts. Thank you.
ありがとうございました。続いて音楽部門のアルボペルトさん、お願いいたします。
Thank you very much. Isn't it a miracle that we here in Tokyo, all five, in a row, are allowed to sit at the table to express our gratitude for this honor. But what is honor? It should be something really great, deep, and serious. We are aware that the greatest honor belongs to our Creator, as well as gratitude. How well it was expressed by Johann Sebastian Bach, that all his works were created to the honor of God. Who of us could and would be able to say so? But if a man is to be honored, it is not an easy task. First, the honor requires sobriety. Indeed, our head must not spin. The one being honored will be forever responsible for this gift. It can be said that this will be a challenge for the rest of his or her life, like a call to order. Honor also means gratitude, mutual gratitude. Being here thankful to all those who have chosen us prize winners from among many of our colleagues. We must comprehend that many others could have been chosen in our stead. The world is rich in talent. Even in war, it happens that if a soldier in the first row should fall, two new men will take his place and victory follows. In the end, I would like to say that the real honor should belong to Premium Imperiale. To us artists, the opportunity has been given to be in the light of that prize because Premium Imperiale, in embracing all the prize winners, is like a father or a mother in large family. We all, therefore, but sons and daughters. Thank you.
ありがとうございました。続いて演劇映像部門のアソルフガードさん、お願いいたします。
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. As I'm sure you can appreciate, it's a rather intimidating experience for me, coming as I do from South Africa, to be sitting next to four such enormous artists. And my story, quite simply, is that the only excuse I have for not knowing much earlier in my life about the Imperial Premium Imperiale was that South Africa is a long way away from everything. I know I've just sat on two aeroplanes in order to get here. And I'm still jet-lagged and zonked out by whatever air travel does to you. But to cut to the chase, as they say, my first encounter with Japan, this is my second, my first encounter with Japan came when I was 21 years old. And I was a sailor on board a tramp steamer. I think that rusty old hulk was one of the last tramp steamers to be sailing the seven seas. And I came to the port of Niigata to offload a cargo of salt, which we had loaded up in Port Sudan. I had hitchhiked through Africa. And that was something you could do in those days. You know, South Africa in that period prior to, well, I don't know what would be the start of it all, was a relatively stable continent. I mean, it's the reason for that is a very hard one, an ugly one as well, which is, of course, colonialism. But I was able to hitchhike right the length of Africa and ended up in Port Sudan, where I joined the ship. And, you know, 60 years is a long time to wait for an experience as extraordinary as this one is for me personally. But I must also say that those 60 years did not see me unaware of Japan. Because at one solitary visit, it was in the middle of a winter, I remember that very clearly, that one visit to Niigata made such an impact on me, my sense of encountering a world and an aesthetic of such ravishing purity, because that seems to me always to be the essence of the great Japanese artists that I've enjoyed over the years, stayed with me. And in the years away from Japan, 60 of them, I'm 82 now, so there's 60 years, I lived with Japan very, very much part of, Japan became very much part of my life. I will elaborate on this later. I just want to say to the people of Premium Imperial that I am humbly grateful to be singled out and to be sitting in the company of the four gentlemen on my left-hand side. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
ありがとうございました。